Welcome, my dear students. Today we are going to be learning the lab program in part B. We are going to be explaining our second program. Okay, our second program is, let us see what is the second program. Design a class to represent a bank account. So we have to design a class which is representing the bank account, including the following members. What are the members we are suggesting? Using constructors. Also, it consists of constructor concept. Use menu driven program. So it is consist of a menu driven program. So if I enter a choice 1, it has to ask for the depositing an amount. If I enter the choice 2, it has to ask for withdraw an amount of after checking minimum balance of 1000. So it has to check minimum balance of 1000 rupees. If I enter 3, it has to display the name and balance. Okay, so let us see what are the data members I have to supposed to use. Name of the depositor, account number, balance amount in the account we have to take, and methods. What are the methods we have to supposed to use? Assign initial values. We have to assign initial values to the constructor. So to do this program, first let me explain you what are the packages I'm using. Import java.lang.star, import java.io.star. These are the packages are essential. And now I am writing the class. The name of the class is bank. Afterwards, I am declaring variables of a string. Here the string variables are name, name of the account holder, as well as account type. ACCR_type means account type. Okay. And next, integer account number. Account number is treated as an integer. And next, float balance. So your balance are treated as a float, and a temporary variable as a float, and withdraw as a float, and deposit variable as float. Now I'm constructing the constructor. What is a constructor? Constructor is a special method which is automatically initialized. Constructor is a special member method function. Sorry, special methods which are automatically initialized whenever an object is created. Then how to identify the constructor? If the name of the class, within the name of the class, if you built a method, okay. So name of the class is bank. I am building this method. This method is a constructor. So in this constructor, I am taking string n, n for the name of the accountant, name of the depositor, right? Name of the account, right? Next, int account number, string account type, float balance. So we have to initialize the first four things. That is name of the account holder, and second one is the account number, and third one is the account type. Account type we have to specify either savings or current or some other, right? And float as balance. Now I am assigning this variable. Here we have declared the name variable, right? For that name variable I am supplying the n value, and for account number I am supplying the account number here, right? And account type I am supplying the account type parameter, and balance, here the balance variable is there. For that balance variable I am assigning the bal parameter, right? So after initializing this, also we are initializing wdraw is equal to 0, withdraw is 0, as well as deposit is equal to 0. Okay, now I am writing one more method. The name of the method is deposit, void deposit float d. So I am taking the d parameter, void deposit float d is there. Here deposit variable is there. Deposit variable you are assigning this dip. Okay, if you are depositing an amount, it will be stored in deposit, and it will add it to the, your balance. For example, if you are having 1000 rupees as a 10,000 in your account, and if you deposit 500, what is the balance now? 10,000 plus 500, that is a 10,500 will be the balance, will be stored here, right? Okay, whatever the deposit amount you are doing, it will be added to your balance. Got it? Yes, that is your deposit logic. And you are writing for the withdraw method, one more method in the class bank, void withdraw. Void withdraw method, float w. W stands for withdraw. Here one condition is given, we have to check the balance. If withdraw less than balance, for example, in your account it consists of 1000 rupees. In your account it consists of 2000 rupees, you just understand. Okay, what is the amount you are having in your account? It is 2000. So now you want to withdraw 1500. Withdraw must be always less than balance, right? 1500 is less than 2000, correct? Yes. If the condition is true, it will enter into this block. But according to your question, one more criteria is given: balance minus withdraw must be greater than or equal to 1000. Okay, so what is the amount in your account? 2000. What is the amount you want to withdraw? 1500. Whether it is possible? Yes, possible, but here it, according to this condition, it is not possible. Okay, balance minus withdraw. After the balance minus withdraw, how much? 500. 500 is greater than or equal to 1000? False. If it is a false, automatically it will come to your else block. Here else block, it is asking for the maintain minimum balance. Got it? If this condition satisfies, and if it is not satisfies, then it will come balance amount is less than withdraw amount. For example, you are having balance as 1000, withdraw is 2000 less than 1000. Condition true or false? False. Automatically it will come here balance amount is less than withdraw amount. Okay, it will display like that. Got it? For example, in your account you are having 10,000. You want to withdraw 2000. Okay, what is the withdraw amount? 2000 less than 10,000. Whether condition is true? True. It will enter here. What is the balance minus withdraw? 10,000 minus 2000, 8,000. 8,000 greater than or equal to 1000. Condition true. If condition is true, what is the withdraw amount? That is W. Okay, so withdraw amount is W. That W is 2000. Balance is equal to balance minus withdraw. Now after withdrawal, what is the balance will exist? 10,000 minus 2000, 8,000. Balance will be 8,000. Got it? Yes, likewise it will evaluate. So this is the logic of your withdrawal. Okay, so first one is the deposit method, as you know. Second one is withdrawal method, now you have learned. And third one is display. If you call this display method, it has to display these outputs. Let us see. Name, it will display the name of name of the person. Second one is account number, it will display the account number. Account number is stored in your account number variable. Account type is stored in your account type variable, that is either current or savings or some others, right? Savings or currents, likewise it will available, and you are doing that. And next, amount deposited. If you deposit the amount, then whatever the deposit amount, it will be stored in your dip variable, right? So deposit amount will be displayed. And next one is amount withdraw. If you withdraw the amount, it will be displayed withdraw variable. And current balance, whatever the balance is available, then balance will be displayed. After displaying that, withdraw and deposit becomes zero. Okay, so these are the methods we have placed in the class bank. These are the methods we have placed in the class bank. Okay, now we are writing one more class. The in this bank class, it doesn't consist any main method. Now you are writing one more class. The name of the class is bank account one. What is the name of the class? Bank account one. Okay, here main method is exist, public static void main, string args, throws exception. Got it? Now after that, you are creating the input object. How to create the input object? Data input stream class. You are creating the object of input stream class of your input file. Okay, system.in. So for the input file, you are creating the input object. Next, you are creating the required variable for your bank class. What are the variables we are supposed to use? Name. Name is exist. Account type is exist. Next, account number we have to enter, that is an integer. Option is equal to 1. We are giving the option and we have to use our choice. Okay. Next, float balance. Balance is exist. And withdraw. Withdraw is exist. Deposit is also exist in your class. So for the above class, whatever the variable we have used, we have to create the same variables in this class also. First, we are writing one output statement, enter the name. So you have to enter the name from the keyboard. So for that, we have created input object db.readline. So whatever the value you are reading from the keyboard is a string. That string will be stored in the name variable. Okay. And next, enter the account number. So account number is an integer, right? So whatever you are entering from the keyboard db.readline, it is a string. You are forcefully converting into integer and you are storing in account number. Okay. Now you are displaying one more output statement. Enter the account type. Account type you are specifying, either it may be current or savings or some others, right? So that is a string. So hence you are using db.readline. You are reading the string value and you are storing in account type. Next, enter the balance. You are displaying one output statement. Enter the balance. Balance is taken as a float, right? So you have to suppose to enter db.readline. Whatever you are entering, it is a string. You are to forcefully convert into float. Float.parsefloat, and you are storing in balance. Okay. Now please observe this line very carefully. This line is you are creating the object of bank class. Okay. What is this line? This line is you are creating the object of a bank class. While creating, you are supplying these values, these variables. Why? Because the constructor concept. So what is a constructor? Constructor is a special method which is automatically used to initialization of an object. So it automatically initialize your object, right? So now bank class, you are creating the object B. How you are saying it is a object? So if you are using new bank, so you are taking the new keyword means you are creating that. For what it is? Bank is the class. So this class object, right? While creating, you are passing name, whatever the value you have read from the keyboard, account number, real account number, account type, as well as balance. You are supplying this automatically. This constructor will initialize. Okay, this constructor will initialize. Got it? And now I'm coming here, and next I'm writing this one do while loop statement. Please observe here, I'm writing do while loop statement. In do, first I'm displaying menu option system.out.println as menu option. Next, system.out.println as it is one format. And next, I'm writing one output statement. If you enter 1, it is a deposit. If you enter 2, it is withdraw. If you enter 3, information with total balance. And next, you are displaying one output statement as enter the choice. So you have to suppose to enter the choice. So if you are entering the choice from the keyboard, you are using db.readline. By using that db.readline, whatever the value you are reading, it is a string. You have to forcefully convert into string. Now you are converting into string and you are storing in ch variable. Now if I give the choice as 1, yes, so if you enter the choice as 1, it is a deposit, and if you enter the choice as 2, it will be withdraw, and if you enter the choice 3, it will show the information with total balance, and you have to enter the choice, right? So for that, whatever the value you are reading the choice is acting as a string. You have to forcefully converting into integer. If you enter the integer, it will store in ch. So now if I enter the choice as 1, so it will matches as a case 1. Okay, 1 equal to 1. What is 1? Deposit. So first it will show output statement amount to be deposit. Enter the amount to be deposit. So deposit variable is declared as a float, right? So now you have to enter the value. Whatever the value you are entering from the keyboard is a string. You are forcefully converting into float and you are storing in the variable deposit. Now you are calling b.deposit. What is b? Object of bank class. So you are calling the deposit method. Where is this deposit method exist? Deposit method will exist in your bank class, right? So suppose if you want to deposit as a 500, it will be come here. So d will be 500 and it will be stored here, and whatever the balance is exist, that balance will be added this deposit amount. Okay, so next, afterwards you are writing break statement. Break statement means it will come out of a switch case statement, and after a switch case statement, it will come here and press 1 to continue. You have to press 1 to continue. So if you have to give 1. Okay, so integer.percent, whatever the value you are entering from the keyboard is a string. You have to forcefully convert into integer and store in opt variable. And now checking the condition while opt equal to option means option. Option equal to 1. Whether condition is true? If the condition is true, once again do while loop will be exist and it will display your menu, and according to the menu you have to give the choices to whatever the value you are reading. It is a string, you have to convert into string to integer and store in choice variable. Now I will withdraw. Okay, now switch choice 2. So case 2 will come. Now for the case 2 we have to develop the program, right? So system.out.println, enter the withdraw amount. So whatever the amount you are entering from the keyboard, it is a string, you have to forcefully convert into float and store in the variable withdraw. Now you are calling b.withdraw. B is the object of class B, class bank, and withdraw is the method of class bank. You are calling with passing the withdraw amount. Okay, whatever the amount you are passed here, it will come here, and here it will pass to the W and checks W less than balance. If this condition is true and if this condition satisfy, then it is possible. Otherwise, it will display maintain minimum balance. Okay, else balance, if the condition is failed first time, then it will show as maintain balance amount is less than withdraw amount. And next, after that, it will break. If the break means, it will come out of the switch case statement, and here it shows press 1 to continue. You have to supposed to press 1 for the continuation, and if you press 1, then option become 1, 1 equal to 1 condition is true. Once again do while loop will be execute and it will show the menu, and now you have to enter the choice as a 3. Whatever the value you are entering from the keyboard is a string, you have to forcefully convert into integer and switch case 3. It will matches to the case 3. What is the case 3? You are directly calling b.display bank object dot display method. So whenever you call, this will be displayed. Name, account number, account type, deposit, withdraw, balance will be displayed. Okay, yes. So likewise it will evaluate this program. If you enter, it will display. After display, it will break, it will come out of the loop, and it will ask for press 1 to continue. If you press the 1 to 1, it will continue. If you press other than 1, it will exit. Okay, it will exit. Okay, let me see the execution of this program. Let me open this program, edit with notepad plus plus. Already it is there. I have written within a one single notepad. Then how to save this file? Bank account. I'm copying and saving as .java. Okay, bank account 1.java. You have to store that in your C drive, JDK 1.4 bin. You have to ensure that you are storing in right path. Okay, after saving that, you have to come here and press the Alt Enter. Now compile your program. Java C bank account 1.java. So there is no error. Now running our program Java bank account 1. So it is asking for the name. I'm giving SMC BCA. Enter the account number 1 2 3 4 5, and enter the account type. I'm giving savings, and enter the balance. I'm showing 5000, and next it is showing the menu. If I press the 1, it is showing as a deposit. I'm storing 1000. Press 1 to continue. I'm pressing 1. It is asking for withdraw or information total balance. I'm pressing 3 option. If I enter the choice 3, it is showing SMC BCA 1 2 3 4 5 savings, and account deposited, account amount withdrawn is 0, current balance is 6000, and press the 1 for the continue. And now I am withdrawing. I am pressing the 2 and press the enter. Withdraw amount, now I am having 6000. Let me make 5000. If I withdraw 5000, no, 5000 is possible. I will make 5500. Please observe here what it will happens. Maintain minimum balance. Minimum balance should be maintained, so it is not possible. And I am pressing 1 to continue, and I am withdrawing. I am giving the choices to. Now I will give the 5000. Whether 5000 is possible? Yes, possible, because 6000 minus 5000, 1000, 1000 greater than or equal to 1000 condition is true. Yes. Okay. Now I am pressing the 1 to continue, and now I am displaying the information. If I display that, current balance is shown, and withdrawn amount is also shown, deposit is not showing. Yes, here we are pressing 1 to continue. So likewise it is showing if you withdraw once again, let you give it as a 200, it will show maintain minimum balance. Minimum balance is compulsory. Okay, got it? Yes. Likewise if you press 1 to continue, it will continues and it will show now the information. And if you want to continue 1, and if you want to deposit 1, you can give it as any amount. I'm giving 9000 and press 1 to continue and see the information. If you see this, current balance is, amount deposited is 9000 and current balance is 10000. Got it? Yes. Likewise it will evaluate if you give other than 1, it doesn't continue. I give 0, it will terminate. As you know how to copy that, right? How to copy this output, as you know. So before that, while executing this, you just try to give the clear screen, okay, and edit it, mark. So you try to mark now. After selection of entire answer, you have to press the enter key. You have to press the enter key, right? Okay. So likewise you can evaluate it. Hope you understand this concept and this program. This program is also very very important. Afterwards you have to paste it. Not copied, I think so. Okay, no problem. So you just try to copy it, okay, and do your documentation. So that is about your second program. Okay, so likewise your program will evaluate, and we have shown how to execute this program also. Okay, if you enter the choice other than 1, it will terminate. Okay.